English Standard 5 Unseen Passage. Unseen passages are the passages which are not presented in the textbook. They are also known as unseen passage. Comprehension of an unseen passage means a complete and thorough understanding of the passage. The main object of comprehension is to test one's ability to grasp the meaning of a given passage properly and also one's ability to understand in one's own words the questions based on the passage. We are going to read a passage and try and answer the questions. This is your first passage. I'm reading it for you. My name is Joy. My uncle Moby lives in a farmhouse. I love to go there in holidays. There are many animals in his farmhouse. There are two cows and a calf. There is a horse and a mare. There are three pigs and two piglets too. There is a beautiful pond in the farmhouse. There are three ducks in the pond. Small chicks are there with a hen. A windmill is also there in the farmhouse. So children, this is a passage. Here are certain questions and we have to find the answers from the passage. But while writing the answers from the passage, we have to frame our own sentences. You don't have to just copy the answers from the passage and write. So the first question is, what is the name of the boy in the passage? The name of the boy in the passage is Joy. So you can't write my name is Joy. You just have to write what? The name of the boy in the passage is Joy. Second question, what is the name of Joy's uncle? The name of Joy's uncle is Uncle Moby. The next question, where does Uncle Moby live? Uncle Moby lives in a farmhouse. My Uncle Moby lives in a farmhouse. We can't write this full sentence. We have to frame in our own sentence. So what will be the answer? The name of Joy uncle is Uncle Moby. And where does Uncle Moby live? Uncle Moby lives in a farmhouse. The next question, when does Joy go to the farmhouse? Joy goes to the farmhouse in his holidays. How many cows are there in the farmhouse? There are two cows in the farmhouse. How many horses are there in the farmhouse? There is one horse in the farmhouse. How many piglets are there in the farmhouse? There are two piglets in the farmhouse. Is there any pond in the farmhouse? Yes, there is a pond in the farmhouse. The answers are written in the own sentences. We have to write the answers in our own sentence. You don't have to copy it just from the passage and write. Which animal is there in the pond? There are ducks in the pond. How many windmills are there in the farmhouse? There is one windmill in the farmhouse. So children, I hope you all have understood how to find out the answers from the passage and write in your own words. So here is a passage. You have to read it and there are certain questions behind. You have to find out your own answers from this passage. These are the questions from the passage. You have to find your own answers with the help of the passage. You have to find your own answers. You don't have to copy the answers. I have given the answers behind in the slide, but try to find your answers on your own and then you can check the answers which are there behind. So two passages are given for your homework. You have to copy it in your composition book. Thank you. This is the second passage. You have to read the passage twice and then answer the questions which are given behind. These are the questions. You have to frame your own answers with the help of a passage. Try to find your own answers and then you can check the answers from the slide. Thank you.